everyone, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Today we're gonna show you guys how to fix a problem that I've been having with my new router. So I just purchased this new router yesterday, wireless N router, so it's a pretty quick wireless router. So the problem that I have with it is that, so this is my computer and I've set the router up. I've set up the Wi-Fi so that all my computer devices at home can connect to it. So if I connect to this with my computer, and just ignore the Chinese there for a second, basically it means that I've connected to the router. And you can see here down the bottom right hand corner, it's got a connection icon. And what this is saying is that there is no internet. Okay, internet is not available. So if you go on the internet, notice if I try to go on Google right now, nothing comes up. Okay, it doesn't work. The next thing I want to show you is how the home network is set up. I have two devices. I have a wireless router and I have an ADSL 2 Plus modem. Now, nowadays you can usually get them both as one device. Okay, so this is part of the problem why it's not working. So if you have a look at my router, okay, this is the new router that I've just purchased. These are the ports on the back of the router and you can see that it has four LAN LAN ports and one WAN port. So the WAN port, this line here, is connected directly to my modem. Now the problem with the modem is that it is not wireless, which means that if I wanted to turn it into a wireless router, I need this device. The problem that's occurring right now is that there is internet on the modem and then the internet goes through my router, but it doesn't get through to my computer. So how do we fix this? Well, firstly, let's start configuring the router on our computer. So what you need to do to get to the router configuration page is, firstly, you need to go into command prompt by typing CMD in the bottom left-hand corner of your Windows. And the reason why you do that is because you can type in ipconfig/all, and that shows you all the network configuration addresses on your computer. And right now you can see that the default gateway, okay, it has two default gateways. It has 10.0.0.138 and it has 192.168.0.1. Now the default gateway basically means where the IP address of the router. Now, what is the problem here? Well, this is saying that there are two routers in your house. There are two routers in your house and each one of them is doing the function of a router. So how does that work? Well, if you have a look at my two devices, I have a modem and I have a wireless router. Now the modem is actually got a router function built in, okay, because basically the function of a router is to pass data between networks. Okay, so the data packets are coming from the network outside of your house to the network inside of your house. So the modem is acting as a router, and so is this router. So basically what we're about to do is to turn the router function in this router off and only use the modem as the router. And what we're also going to do is basically have this router turned into a switch. So what is a switch? A switch basically means that it gives this router additional ports. Okay, it gives this router, how many ports does this modem have? It has one Ethernet port and one USB port. So originally, this router can only have two computers connected to it. But with this additional switch, okay, I'm going to show you how to turn this into a switch in a second. It can have a lot more computers connected to it because there are four ports at the back for Ethernet connections. And then it's got the wireless function as well to allow even more computers to connect to this router. But right now we want to turn the router function off in this router so that this turns into just a switch. Okay, so let me show you how to do that. So right now there are two addresses for the IP address of the router. Okay, and you have to try out each one to see which device it is pointing to. But let's try the 192.168.0.1. 192.168.0.1. Okay, so I'm typing that in at the address bar at the top. Okay, and now it says log in to your TP-Link wireless end router. So now I know that I've chosen the correct IP address. So I'm going to log in with this password that should be provided to you in your user manual. So log into it. And this is my router page. And to turn the router function off so that it becomes just a switch is basically you go to the left where it says DHCP and you're going to change this DHCP server from enable to disable. Okay, so let me explain what DHCP server means. It means that it is the server responsible for giving out IP addresses to all the computers on your network, on your home network. So basically, if you have a look at the two devices here, this router, this modem, ADSL 2 Plus modem, already has DHCP server enabled on it. So therefore, we turn the DHCP server off on this router, and that will turn it into just a switch. Okay, so before you do this and you click save, keep in mind that if you want to see this page again, you'll have to reset your wireless router back to DHCP server mode, and then you can see this page again. So basically, to reset it, there's a button, usually a button in the back corner of your machine that says reset. And for this particular router, you need to hold it down for 8 seconds before it resets back to factory settings, in which case it'll have DHCP again. So I'm going to disable the DHCP server and I'm going to click save. So click save. And it says the change of DHCP config will not take effect until this device reboots. So click OK. Okay, and then it says click here to reboot. So I'm going to click here. click this button to reboot the device. Okay, reboot it. So now it is restarting. Okay, now I know this looks pretty scary, but this actually means that it's turned into a switch, which is why if you try to get into the router settings page, it doesn't work because it is not the default gateway anymore. Okay, so what you're gonna do now is on your wireless router, where this blue cable connects to your modem, you're gonna move this blue cable, take it out, and you're gonna put it in one of the yellow ports. Okay, because since your ADSL modem is a router and your wireless device and you only want to use it as a switch, it is not responsible as a router, so therefore it is not passing the information from the internet to computers on your network. Your router, your ADSL modem is doing that. Okay, so you can't confuse it by putting the blue cable in the internet port, in the WAN port. So put it in one of your LAN ports, and now this device is acting as a switch, not a router. But the wireless network is still working. Okay, so if you have a look at my computer now, on the bottom right hand corner, it says that I'm connected to the wireless network with the internet. Okay, so if I try to go on the internet now and I put in Google, if I put in Google, it's working. Okay, thanks for watching the video, guys. Hope this has been useful to you. See you next time.